So the goal of WebSocket is to exchange messages between the front end and the back end, or the WebSocket server. For that, let's try to send message from the server to the front end or to the client. So here is our client currently. So I am going, when I connect to that client, I get a message from the server, like for example, "Hello Cryptops." So we can have that message on initialization of the connection of the WebSocket. So when some customer or some client get connected. So for that, you can use a method after connection success, some method which is called emit. So you can use again the socket handler, and then you can type emit. And this method will have two parameters. First parameter is the key which you want to pass for that message, or which can be the key of that message, so the front end can listen to it and read it. And also the other parameter is the content of the message. It can be JSON, it can be normal string, it can be any type of data. So for that, we can specify like "Hello Cryptos Client." So for example, something like that. So we can say that this message will send notification to the user or to the client in the front end that, okay, you are connected to our server. You are allowed to be connected to our server. So let's save, restart our server, and then go again here. But first, you need to create an event. An event which is being the same name of the key of the message which we have created before. So we have a crypto. We can call it a crypto message. You can call it anything. So for that, I will go to the postman and I will click on events, and I will give the same name of the key which I have created in the backend. So the client must know about the key which is used in the backend as well, or in the WebSocket server. So we can have here listen on connect. So we can activate that and go again to messages and then try to connect a client. So when we connect, we got a message called "Hello Cryptos Client." So we directly got the message after successful connection of that client to the server. And as you see here, we have listening to cryptos. Let's try something nice. So for example, I am going to send message every 5 seconds after the connection. So I will say here, if you remember, set interval in JavaScript, which create for me like some possibility to send something or some function every 5 seconds or every second. So I will say here, like the callback will contain, first of all, the emit of the message, and then after the callback as a parameter, I will put the duration. So for example, I will send every second the message "Hello Cryptos Client." So we can specify that on connection. Let's try to connect again. And as you see here, we are getting every second the same message. This set interval method is sending again or executing the code which is inside it in the callback, inside the callback of it, every specified seconds or milliseconds that message. So it's sending through the WebSocket that message every 1 second. And this is what we are going to do. We are going to fetch data from some server and every 5 seconds send those data to client. So every 5 seconds, I fetch data from server and send them to the client. And in that way, we get live updates of the prices from specific API. So in that way, we tested our emit, so we can send messages from server to client. And of course, you can send messages from client to the server, as we will see later. So for now, we can have just this message, "Cryptos, Hello Cryptos Client." So he is connected, he got a message.